Our journey continues at Dover Castle. Today, we're going to look along the western 13th century defensive wall. What we are looking at today was completed by Henry III around the year 1220. Although some bits have been altered in later years, still traces can be seen. Also along our way, we will be looking at later additions that were built. Starting from the cliff edge, the wall runs past Cannon's Gate. Our first stop is a gunpowder magazine, dating from around 1800. The earth bank behind the magazine was added some 50 years later to protect it from seaward bombardment. Next to the gunpowder store is Rokesley's Tower. This is a good example of the 13th century wall and tower. Slightly north of Rokesley's Tower is the Royal Garrison Artillery Barracks. This was built around 1913 for troops that were in charge of the heavy guns at the castle. Not a very old building, but still very impressive looking. Behind the barracks, part of the 13th century wall is visible. Here it shows what the original wall would have looked like. If you look at the top, you can see what looks like a parapet or walkway for allowing people to observe over the wall. At the cliff edge, there's also a parapet. Not much of this has survived, unfortunately. I don't know if this is 13th century, but it could be. Opposite on the other side of the road is the Regiment Institute. This was built in 1868 and was a canteen and recreation rooms. The idea here was to try and tempt the soldiers away from the taverns in the town below. Today, this building houses English heritage offices, visitors canteen, and the most famous piece in the country, the great bronze gun, Queen Elizabeth's pocket pistol. It was cast in Utrecht, Holland, in 1544. It was a 12-pounder brass basilisk. It was presented by the Emperor Charles V to Henry VIII. This gun was not just a showpiece, it saw action at the Siege of Hull in 1643 and again in Sheffield in 1644. In the 19th century, it was known as the Long Gun and mounted on the cliff edge. The gun's carriage was made by the Royal Carriage Department in 1827. It has been reputed to throw a shot 7 miles. To the north of the Institute, there's a small building built in 1894, and this was for storing bread and meat. You can still see the ventilated roof. From the regiment institution, we head over the road to the site of the Cinque Ports prison, built in the 18th century. Here, debtors were condemned by the Lord Warden's Court to jail. Some cells still remain to this day, but unfortunately, not open to the public. Behind the Cinque Ports jail lies Hubert of Dover Tower. The jail was built right in front of it and can only be seen from the top and from the front. It is said that the Fubert of Dover Tower was rebuilt by Edward IV in the later 15th century, and is both rectangular and different in appearance from its 13th century neighbours. Rokesley, Hurst, Says and Gattons Towers are all semicircular. From here we have a great view of the rest of the towers. Hurst Tower we can see inside. There seems to be some sort of alteration. This red brick chimney, possibly a later addition. Says Tower has a door on it and unfortunately closed to the public at this time. Gattons Tower has a long slit opening, most likely used for longbow use back in the day. In the 1800s, William Twiss altered the 13th century wall. He lowered the height of the walls to allow cannon fire, possibly 12 pounders mounted there. Earth was placed up behind the wall to make them more resistant to artillery attack. Throughout my series of Dover Castle, we are going to hear more from William Twiss due to the amount of work he has done within the periods of the 18th and 19th centuries, fortifying Dover Castle.